Hi, this is Kanna Babu. In the last class, we discussed about how to update the stock and the roles of salesperson. Here, the salesperson will log in and salesperson will view the stock details. Salesperson will make the sales. He can generate the bill and he can recover the forget password. These are the roles of what? Salesperson. So, here if you observe, I have designed this page. So here you can see I will log in with salesperson, username is Anil and password is Anil, and click on sign in, and it will successfully go to salesperson home.cs. Here I have three in the menu strip control. I have three menu items. One is view stock, make sales and log out. Whenever I click on view stock, if you observe clearly, I want to display the username. So here you see, this is salesperson home.cs. Here I have taken one menu strip control and here I have taken one label, and here if you observe, I will go to the solution explorer. There you can see salesperson home.cs and salesperson login.cs. Within this salesperson login.cs, here I have taken one property to declare. I have taken one static property, public static string uname. And here I set the value for the property. When user clicks on the button, I store the username in the property, static property. And within this salesperson home.cs, I'll try to display that value in the label control. Welcome plus salesperson login dot uname, class name dot property name. That is the reason you can display here. When I try to log in with Anil and Anil, it has to display welcome Anil in the next form. And salesperson can view the stock. So when I click on view stock, I already designed this form, view stock. And in this, what is the requirement in this form? Here I have to write some programs. Like if you observe here, program number one is, program number one, bind item types in combo one, combo box one. And then program number two is, when user selects combo 1, when user selects combo box 1, display the selected items, display the selected items in combo 2. It means that when user selects pizza, I want to display all the pizzas, like veg pizza, chicken pizza in combo box 2. Similarly, if he selects burger, I want to display veg burger, chicken burger in combo box 2. And whenever I select any name item in the combo box 2, I want to display that quantity and price from items table. So that is my requirement. I think we already developed this similar screen in update stock, but here I want to develop this one with data reader. Right. So here if you want, I will try to use data reader. For this I will use a stored processors also. First of all, I will create one stored processor, something like, my procedure will look like this. Create procedure, procedure name, proc underscore bind item types, bind item types here as begin block, end block. Here I will write the query to make the thing fast. So here execute the query, press F5. If you want to execute the procedure, select the procedure name, press F5. You got all the item types, right? So this is my procedure name. I want to display that here I will write one method within my viewstock.cs. Here I will write a separate method, something like private void bind item types, bind item types. I want to do this example with stored processors. To make the things faster, I will directly write. So here I already written the code. I declared one method called bind item types. There I create the connection, open the connection, pass the procedure name. And here if you want, you can add mention that we are working with stored processors, and cmd dot command type is equals to command type dot stored procedure. And here I execute the query because the result of the query is a single column. So I am using execute reader method. If the data reader is having rows, I want to read all the records. Here why I use while loop means there are multiple records, there are multiple values that are available in that particular column. So to read all the records, I use that while loop, and I want to display in the combo. check the output once. Here I will try to log in with my username Anil and password is Anil. Click on sign in, view stock. So I displayed all the item types in combo 1. So here whenever user selects the combo box 1, any item in the combo box 1, then I want to display that item related items in item names in combo box 2. So if you observe clearly in my database, something like select star from, there is one table called item master, and select star from items. So what is my requirement here? Right, if you observe the requirement, I want to display the item names belongs to what? Pizza. If I ask you to write a query to display the item names belongs to pizza, what is the query you will write? Join query I will write. Select. Joins are used to retrieve the data from more than one table. And whatever the data you want, you can access the data based on table name or alias name. So here I will write select items dot iname from item master inner join items, item master inner join items on. Here you can write item master dot itype number is equals to items dot itype number. When you execute the above query, it will display all the matching records, but I want only pizza, where itype is equals to, I want pizza, P-I-Z-Z-G-A, press F5. So I think, I execute the total query. I want to execute only join query, press F5. I got veg pizza and chicken pizza. So I'll paste the same procedure, same code here. So I will keep this entire code inside a procedure. So here you can see create procedure. Procedure name proc underscore bind item names. Bind item names. Here you can write as begin block and here you can write end block. I want to pass the parameter for the procedure at the rate i type. Data type I'll give as something like here you can see at the rate i type. Yes, data type I want to give as something like varchar of 30 I want to give here. Right, so here also I will modify itype is equals to @itype. This is my procedure. Right, press F5, copy the procedure name. Here my procedure name is proc underscore bind item names. So I will go to viewstock.cs. Here you can observe. I'll just go to viewstock.cs and here I will try to double click on combo box 1 and write the code. So here I create the connection, open the connection, pass the procedure, and here I pass the value input as selected item. Now I want to execute this form. So here you can see the username is Anil and password is Anil. Click on sign in. Here you can click on view stock. It is displaying all the, if I select pizza, then automatically combo box 1 event is fired. And here you see veg pizza and chicken pizza. If I select burger, press F5. And here you can see veg burger and chicken burger. But the previous items are not removing. So what I will do here? Here I will write one code, something like CB item name dot items dot clear. Is it clear? So here whenever I select the item type for second time, it has to clear the previous items. So again I will try to log in with my username Anil and click on sign in. And here I will click on view stock. Here you can check. I will select pizza and here I will select veg pizza. Right. And whenever I will select the burger, it has to clear the veg pizza and chicken pizza. And the same time it has to clear the selected item also. So what I will try to do here? After this, I will try to write CB item name dot text is equals to empty. Is it clear? And apart from that, when user clicks on view stock, this combo box, I want to display the quantity and what price. I think I have written the stored procedure for that to display the quantity and price. Right. 1 minute. I will write the procedure for that to display the quantity and price. So I'll go to the new query and here I'll create a procedure. So this is my procedure. Select quantity comma price from items where iname is equal to @iname. So here double click on combo box 2 and write the code. So my code will looks like this. So here I create the connection, open the connection, pass the procedure, mention that we are working with stored procedure, and I passed the value. What is the value I have passed? Selected item, cb item dot selected item dot to string. So if I give the input as veg pizza, so this procedure will get executed and it will get the quantity and price of veg pizza. And I want to display the quantity in quantity text box and price in amount text box. So once debug and check the output here, I'll try to log in with Anil, and Anil, click on sign in. So salesperson will view the stock details. I'll select the item type pizza, and here you can say I got veg pizza and chicken pizza. So the salesperson, when customer come to the shop, for example, the customer is asking, I want 5 veg pizzas. So first of all, salesperson must check whether that veg pizzas are available in the shop or not. The item name veg pizza 30. The available veg pizzas are 30, and the price of veg pizza is 60. And then here I will try to modify the design, something like within the viewstock.cs I will change this one. The button I will give as make sales, and if the items are available, he will make the sales. Is it clear? That is the requirement. So I hope you understood this form. So in this video, we completed about the view stock form. Initially, we binded the item types. Then when user selects the item types, we displayed the item names in combo 2. When user selects the item name, then we display the quantity and price of that particular item. If you want, you can enter some another item details also. Anil and Anil, sign in, click on view stock. For example, I'll select the cool drink. So here Sprite is there. The total number of Sprites that are available are 40, and the price is 22 rupees. For more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. And apart from that, you can log into my Facebook group. This is my personal Facebook group. Thank you. In the next part, we'll discuss about make sales screen. Right? Have a nice day.